Got it, China? 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 Here we are negotiating in good faith. They are not. So here's the deal. If China continues to play around like this, refusing to keep up its end of the bargain, then we engage in retaliation. We can make China's life much harder economically. I promise you that.
Dear Trish, perhaps you need a better research team.
The Chinese are launching a full-scale information war against the United States of America and their newest target, me, while they accuse me of just not knowing my research, which China, I do.
Regan blamed three times the Chinese for stealing billions from the Americans.
And yeah, the Chinese are stealing from us. They're stealing intellectual property.
According to her, we don't really have a choice but to wage this war. Words have consequences.
I said economic war, and we're in one, and we're winning it. Of course, we will, and we should, and we will fight to make world markets more fair. Fair for us. We deserve it.
Her economic warmongering reaches millions of Americans in their homes and possibly many others around the world.
That anchor is reading a script that seems, I guess, to have no emotion because she doesn't seem to read it as though she's had any hand in writing it. State media.
And given the close, almost symbiotic relationship that the Fox channel has with the current U.S. administration, it's fair to say she also speaks for Trump's America.
I'm not here to tout anyone's view but my own. I can only articulate what I personally believe is right for our country.
She portrays America as the real victim here, implying that previous U.S. administrations were somehow suckered by the scheming Chinese. Yet, in carefully analyzing her words, it's all emotion and accusation supported with a little substance.
Okay, for the record, any emotion you see is quite real. But hey, I guess to the Chinese state-run media, I get it. I'm just a girl, right? I'm just an American girl. So I clearly couldn't know what I'm talking about, right? Of course, I must be all emotion and no substance. Okay, China, here's a little insight into how we American women think. We're damn smart, and we will willingly respond with emotion when presented with a set of facts like this.
The kind of language being used against China has been derogatory, to say the least. War, weapons, stealing, even that our country is raping their economy. By the way, how do you rape an economy?
They must be really, really nervous because tonight they're hitting me. If they're not calling me emotional, they're trying to scare people with the power they perceive me to have.
This is not the language of a trade partner, but the insults you might hurl at an enemy. The US side did not hesitate to brandish the weapon and slap higher tariffs on China.
China, if you're fair with us, I suspect we will be fair with you. But don't think for 2 seconds that this nonsense of you taxing our goods while we allow yours to come into this country duty-free, don't think that's going to continue. Mm-mm.
Now, 1 year after the trade frictions first erupted, China itself is finally calling this a trade war.
For the record, I didn't say war.
Can you negotiate with people who cross the line of decency? I don't think so. When they issue unreasonable demands, compounded by virtually pointing a gun at your head, in this case, of course, tariffs, even if you wanted to engage, you simply can't.
China, listen up. You've picked the wrong fight here. Play fair, trade fair, or don't trade at all.
Well, this is the 21st century. The days when you could arm twist a country to accept unequal treaties ended long ago. The Chinese people rejected such treaties back then and will do so today as well. For people like Trish Regan or anyone else who thinks that economics should be weaponized against China, they'll be disappointed. Two can play at that game.
I have dared to say we should engage in economic warfare.